होमोजीनियस फंक्शन द डेफिनेशन इज अ फंक्शन एफ ऑफ एक्स वाई ऑफ टू वेरिएबल्स एक्स एंड वाई इज सेड टू बी होमोजीनियस फंक्शन ऑफ डिग्री एन इफ सम ऑफ द इंडाइसेस ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई इन एवरी टर्म इज सेम एंड इट इज इक्वल टू एन. सो वी से दैट द फंक्शन इज अ होमोजीनियस फंक्शन ऑफ डिग्री एन if sum of indices in all the terms of x as well as y is same. Clear? Noted down the definition. A function f of xy of two variables. Finish writing up to this. Yes. Did you all complete?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Homogeneous function. Homogeneous in chemistry also you have learnt about homogeneous, it gets mixed, we cannot separate it, right? So likewise a function f of xy, it should be same, uniform. So a function f of xy of two variables x and y is said to be homogeneous of degree n if the variables x and y or their sum of the variables, sum of the indices of x and y in every term is same and it is equal to n, then we say that the homogeneous function is of degree n. But every time it is not possible for me to check whether every given term in the function or every variable x and y for the given function is giving rise to the same indices or not. So therefore we have one m test with which we can understand whether the given function is homogeneous or not. So, for example, if we write f of xy as this, so in every term, if you see x to the power n, n minus 1 plus 1 kya dega? N. N minus 2 plus 2 kya dega? N. So, everywhere we see that the term is n, sum of the indices, it is equal to n. So, this is called as homogeneous function of degree n. Write this. For f of xy, a0 x to the power n, a1 x to the power n minus 1, y to the power 1, a2 x to the power n minus 2, y square. Everywhere if you see, sum of indices of x and y is same and it is equal to n. So we call this as homogeneous function of degree n. Where a0, a1, an are constants. Clear? Homogeneous function of degree n where a0, a1, a2 up to an are constants. Completed up to this?
Yes, sir.
So yes, another sir. Way of denoting it. Now, other way of writing it is either you can express it as y by x or you can express it as x by y. Kya hoga if I take x to the power n common? So, everywhere 1x will be reduced. So, it will be attached to the y in the denominator. So, it can also be written as f of xy is equal to x to the power n outside a0 plus a1. 1 x to the power n is outside, so this x to the power minus 1 becomes y upon x. This x to the power minus 2 becomes y upon x whole square. And lastly, you get an into y by x to the power n. Right? So, a homogeneous function can also be expressed as x to the power n into function of y by x, y to the power n into function of x by y. This is the way how you can find out the function as homogeneous. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, which is a homogeneous function of degree n? Everywhere, what is outside? Which power or index is outside? N. So, this is also another way for denoting the function as homogeneous of degree n. Noted up to this?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Homogeneous function of degree n. In other words, what I was talking about m test is, in other words, function f of xy is homogeneous of degree n if x is replaced by mx, y is replaced by my, and after simplification you are getting m to the power n into original function. Then this particular test is called as M test for finding out the degree of the homogeneous function and to check whether the given function is homogeneous or not. Right? So mostly we will be applying this M test for finding out whether the given function is homogeneous or not, and if it is homogeneous, what is the degree of that homogeneous function. So what we have to do, whatever is the original given function, I have to replace that x with mx, y with my. After simplifying, take m to the power n, some power of m outside, which should be left with the original function. If it is so, I can say that function is homogeneous of degree n. Ki m ka power kya nikla hai? N. So therefore, I can say that it is a homogeneous function of degree n, and this particular test for identifying whether the function is homogeneous or not is M test. It is called as M test. Clear up to this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Note, the degree n of a homogeneous function can be rational number also. Rational number means of the form p by q, q not equal to 0. So it can be fraction 1, minus 1 by 2, 1 by 16, etc. Ye m test samajh mein aaya? We will be solving one example related to this m test before moving or switching over to the new topic, right? Homogeneous function is the basic for learning Euler's theorem. Learning Euler's theorem. Euler's theorem is again one of the important theorem which is applied only to the homogeneous function to get the desired result. So mostly we will be dealing with the examples related to Euler's theorem. But for that Euler's theorem, it is mandatory for us to understand the concept of homogeneous function. So degree n of a homogeneous function can be rational number. It can be generalized for function of several variables, that is x, m. Ye nahi likha to bhi chalega. Second point is not required. Only you write down the first. Degree n of a homogeneous function may be any rational number, 1, minus 1 by 2, 1 by 16. this can be generalized. No need to write that generalized statement for the homogeneous function, right? Note it down, the first point.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now tell me, these are the oral questions for identification. Is this function homogeneous? What is the definition of homogeneous? We can go with every term contains the same index or sum of the indices. Yes, is same. Yes, here it is x square. Means what is the index or power of the variable?
2.
Two. Two. In the middle term it is xy. What is the power or sum of the powers or indices of the two?
2.
2. Y ka power bhi kitna hai yahan par?
2.
2. Means every term is giving the power or index as 2. Means it is a homogeneous function of degree. It 2. Is a homogeneous function of degree 2. But as I discussed now, I will have to check it with the help of M-test. M-test kya kehta hai? Whatever is the given function, you replace x by mx and you replace y by my, then whatever will be the power of m taken outside multiplied by the original function, we can say that it is homogeneous of degree n. So replace x by mx, so ye ho jayega mx whole square, mx into my, my whole square. In every term if you see, m square is common, m into m is m square. Here also it becomes m square. Here also it becomes m square. So it is m square multiplied by the original function, x square plus xy plus y square. So I am getting m square multiplied by the original function. So I can say that yes, it is expressed in the form m to the power n into f of xy. So it is a homogeneous function of degree
2.
And orally also I have already calculated sum of the index in the term, or the powers are same throughout the polynomial, throughout the function. So 2 2 2, so obviously it is homogeneous function of degree 2. But I have to practice with the help of M test, because that is what I am going to use it later. Is this M test clear? Logic of M test or concept of M test is clear? Completed with this? So it is a homogeneous function of degree 2, right?
Yes, sir.
Take the next one, x square into cos of y by x. Replace every x and y by mx my, mx whole square, cos of my upon mx, m square x square cos of y by x. Mm is getting cancelled, right? So it is a homogeneous function of degree
2.
Clear? M to the power n into original function. M square into x square cos of y by x. So it is a homogeneous function of degree 2. Right? Clear up to this?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Now third one. Z is equal to tan inverse of x square plus y square upon x plus y. Inverse mein se bahar nikal sakte kya aap m ko? Yes?
No, sir.
Can you calculate, can you take out m outside from this inverse? No. To uske liye kya karenge?
No.
Tan inverse ko to be taken on the other side. So kya banta hai? Tan z. Tan z is equal to x square plus y square upon x plus y. Now you replace this mx and my. So क्या होगा? m square x square plus m square y square upon mx plus my. Clear? From the numerator, what can be taken common? M square.
M square.
From the denominator, what can be taken common?
M.
M.
Are you getting the original function then?
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. Z is not homogeneous. What is homogeneous?
Tan Z.
Tan Z. Because if I have kept this tan inverse on the same side, it is not possible for us to take M common from inverse. So I remove this tan inverse. To remove tan inverse, take tan on both the sides. Right? So m square upon m is m. So it is homogeneous of degree 1. Is this clear? But
yes,
z
sir.
Is not homogeneous. Sir. Tan z is homogeneous of degree 1. Because I cannot proceed with keeping tan inverse on the RHS. I have to shift that. Unless and until I do, I cannot prove that function is homogeneous. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So tan z is a homogeneous function of degree n is equal to 1. Lastly, will this be homogeneous function? Here it is y square, here it is x square, here it is 1. Are the terms homogeneous or is the term having degree same?
No, sir.
यहाँ पर सिग्नल
होगा
m square x square, यहाँ पर होगा mx, here it will be m square y square. If I take out m common, will it be original function? क्या बचेगा? mx square plus x plus my square. I am not getting the original function क्योंकि mm associated है. So is this homogeneous?
No.
No.
No, sir.
Clear? So this is not a homogeneous function. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So write down the statement of this Euler's theorem and we stop. Proof is not mandatory. Euler's theorem on homogeneous function. If f of xy is homogeneous function of x and y in degree n, then x into del f by del x plus y into del f by del y is equal to n into f. This is the statement of Euler's theorem on homogeneous functions.